It is that time of the year once again, and by that time we mean it's the time around Independence Day, which again means that Akshay Kumar would be coming up with his movies. Yes, last year it was Rustam, and this year too he is coming on Independence Day with Toiletic Prem Katha, which released today in theatres in the nation. For a long time, Bollywood has been wanting a blockbuster that can make some mark in the box office. Would Toilet Ek Prem Katha be that film that would break the Bollywood jinx in 2017? Let's see. The story is about Keshav, which is played by Akshay Kumar, and Jaya, played by Bhumi Pednekar. And it's a love story basically, but this love story is a little hatke. It's not like there's some very obvious obstacle, like the family is not accepting or they are star-crossed lovers. But the major problem in their love story is a toilet. This movie tries to look into the very relevant factor of open defecation that almost 54% of Indian population still face. After a lot of hardships, Keshav finally gets to marry Jaya. But Jaya leaves Keshav because he doesn't have a toilet at his house and she can't go for open defecation. So the story is more or less very predictable and known, but what is very different here is the treatment of the story. The first half of the movie was light and had many comic moments, but from the second part it gets a little intense. But there is no point in the movie where you will feel a disconnect. Throughout the film, you won't find a disconnect and you will be hooked to your seats till the very end. The handling of the subject and treatment of the narrative is commendable, but by the end, the movie becomes a little elongated ad for Swachh Bharat movement. Desi Martini audience has given the film 3 out of 5 stars for its story. The film boasts of a strong performance. While Akshay Kumar carries the entire film almost effortlessly on his shoulders, Bhumi Pednekar too does an equally great job. Akshay Kumar, as usual, gives a brilliant performance and is very believable in all the scenes. Not only does he do all the emotional and the intense parts very well, but his comic parts is also worth a watch. This is the second film for Bhumi Pednekar, who gave a great debut with Dam Laga Ke Haisha, and she is proving that she is here to stay. While there was scope for her to get overshadowed by the overwhelming aura of somebody like Akshay Kumar, she firmly holds her ground and comes up as a character of her own. She is brilliant in her performance, but she falters when it comes to the diction and accent. There is scope for much improvement on that area. Amongst the supporting cast, Devendu Sharma and Sudhir Pandey does a commendable job. There is also Anupam Kher, who has a short role but he shines in every frame that he appears in. He is that guy who could be comic and serious at the same time, and that's the best part about his character. For performance, Desi Martini audience has given the film 4 out of 5 stars. While the work of the director might not come in the forefront, director Srinarayan Singh has actually done a fabulous job in turning a very simple story to a full-fledged commercial film. The storyline can already be guessed from all the teasers, trailers and promo, and we know what would be the outcome of the film. Yet, there won't be a moment where you would want to take your eyes off the screen. He captures the simple rustic lifestyles, the culture of rural India with all its orthodox tradition and beliefs, and tries to delve into the psyche and what goes on in the minds of the people when it comes to making toilets at their own houses. He should definitely be getting a nomination in this year's awards ceremony at least. For direction, the film has got 3.5 out of 5 stars from the Desi Martini audience. The editing and cinematography of Toilet Ek Prem Katha is also one of the strongest features of the film. Set in a rural background, somewhere around Mathura in Uttar Pradesh, the film captures the sights, the sound, the colors of the place very beautifully. Srinarayan Singh has been an editor himself, so you could expect that the editing of the film should be excellent, and it really is. There isn't any loose point in the film, though at the end, the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan thing extends for a little too long, but your attention won't be dwindling at any point in the film. For editing and cinematography, the film has got 4 out of 5 stars from the Smartini audience. The music of the film is average. The only 2 songs that stay with you when you come out of the theatre are Gori to Latmar and Hasmat Pagli Pyar Ho Jayega, which you have already seen in the promos. The background music though blends perfectly well with the entire narrative of the film. For music, the film has got 3 out of 5 stars from the Smartini audience. The film definitely lives up to the hype that it had created and is an entertaining watch all throughout. You would want to sympathize with Jaya and Keshav all throughout. After a very long time, there is a film that won't leave you completely disappointed when you walk out of the theatre. It's totally entertaining and paisa vasool, and you should definitely go to the theatres near you and watch this movie. Overall, the movie has got 3.3 stars out of 5 in Desi Marti. In case you are planning to watch this movie, do not forget to rate and review it on Desi Martini. We will be back with another review next week. Till then, stay tuned with us and follow us on Desi Martini website and Desi Martini app.